This thing, it's a wastegate valve controller. This was removed by me a couple of days ago from a BMW 7 Series G11 750i. On that car, this thing will control the wastegate from the turbocharger. And on that particular engine, N63, there are two of these, because that engine have two turbochargers. This unit is bad, that's why it's here, that's why it was removed. And this thing will throw a couple of error codes. Some of them were about open circuit or short circuit, and a lot of them about the position of the linkage. In this video, I will try to disassemble this unit to see if I'm able to find what can go wrong inside of this valve controller and to understand how the system is working. So if you are curious like me, you're in the right place, so don't go anywhere. First thing, I will try to power up the electric motor that will move this linkage to see if this is working, and I will try to stress it with heat, because this is mounted on the turbochargers and this thing will be in contact with a lot of heat. First, I will need to see on the wiring diagram. This is the electrical wastegate valve. This thing from here have 5 pins, and I can see from here pin 1 and 5 are for the electrical motor, and pin 2, 3, and 4 are for the position sensor. But here in this schematic, they don't show me which one it's which. For example, here I have the throttle valve, and here you can see the electric motor, pin 1 and 2, and the rest of the pins have 2 position sensors. And here this system will show me, this schematics will show me which pin is which and what pin is the signal and what pin is the supply. For example, this pin, it's 5 volts supply. This pin, it's ground. And these 2 pins are for the position. These are the signal that will be sent to the control unit, to the engine control unit. These 2 things are the engine control unit. So here, oh, here you can see, I can see it now. 5 volts, this is the voltage for this sensor. The pin 3, I think it's ground, and pin 4 is the signal. Yeah, I think the M stands for the ground, and A is for the signal. You can see it, M ground and A signal, and this is the same, and ground and A signal, but here in this schematic won't show me inside of the valve. Okay, now if I know that, next step is to find the pins. And you can see pin 1 it's in the right and pin 5 it's in the left. Okay, now I will need 2 pins. 1 and the second one. I will connect these 2 in pin 1 like so, and 5. In 1 and 5. Now I will power up my power supply, 12.6 volts. Let's see here. Okay. It's working and it sounds good. And I don't see any problem. Every time this is working good. Maybe it's a problem with the position sensors from inside and not the electric motor. But before everything, I want to test this controller when it's very hot. For example, at this moment, this controller have 29 degrees Celsius or 84 degrees Fahrenheit. I will start my heat gun. This is set to 300 degrees Celsius. And I will start to apply heat. I think it's enough. I will let this air gun to cool down. Okay, now this thing is hot, 180 degrees Fahrenheit or 82 degrees Celsius. Okay, let's see. It's working. But it has a different sound. For sure. Okay, let's heat it more. Okay, let's test it again. It's very, very hot. 120 degrees to 40. And it's not working anymore. So this is affected by temperature. Now I leave it connected with the power supply to see when the electric motor will kick back. Now there is a chance to have inside a thermal protection, a thermal resistor or a thermal switch to disconnect the motor. Now you can see it, now it's working. Okay, maybe this controller have a thermal protection inside, and when the temperature is above the rated temperature of the protection, will disconnect the electric motor. But I will need to open it. So, it's very hot. First I will need to leave this valve to cool down. After a rapid cool down in the sink, in the water, now the temperature is acceptable. I need to see how I will be able to open it. And from what I see, here is the point where this valve controller is connected together from with these two parts. But this is melted together. I have here this thing, but I have pulled it and it's not moving. So I think I need to break it apart. But I'm seeing something interesting here. Something interesting. Here I see these two metal wires that at one time have been cut, and on this side the same. Here you can see it better. You see them? Don't tell me this is what I'm thinking. Let me check first. These two wires are connected together. No, this is the water. This is very sensitive, you can see. 1.2 mega ohms between my fingers. And this is bigger. They are not connected. Okay, let me try to see if the upper wire is connected to this one. Yeah, it's connected. 0.7 ohms. And the lower wire, yeah, the same, it's connected. 0 ohms. I think this thing, it's melted together, but to be melted, they have used some wire from here that will exit here, and from here that will exit on this part. They have put voltage on these wires, melt the plastic and bond it together. And after that, they have cut the excess wire. So let me put some voltage across these wires to see what happened. But I'm not sure. This is what I'm thinking this will be. Let me check secondly to see if these things are connected somehow with the pins. No. No, they are not connected. Okay. Let me see. This one, this one. Yeah, this is pulling 5 amps. You can see it on the power supply. It's like almost a short. But my power supply is not strong enough. So I will use a battery. That is stronger. Let me see if I will make a big flash. Yeah, yeah, it's, I think this thing is what I think it is, because this part is very hot. But I think the voltage is bigger. Here, what I think was a small voltage with a big amperage used to do this. No, the voltage is too big. I will use my power supply with the reduced amperage. That power supply is capable of 5 amps. Yeah, it's very hot, but it's not opening. Or maybe that wires are for something else and I'm putting voltage over them without any scope. But it's very, very hot here in this area where the case is closed, is bond. And here is hot also. Okay, I will use the plan B. I will use safety glasses because I know how painful it is. I'm doing too much mess here with this thing and I don't like it. Whew. What a mess. Thank you. Okay, I will finish cleaning later. Now we need to see what inside of this controller. Okay. Wow. Yeah. This is full of this carbon thing. You can see it. This here is the sensor. Push this inside. And this here is the motor. And if I'll apply voltage here, nothing. It's not moving because it's not centered anymore. This thing from here, I think, will center it. Yeah, for sure. This here are some brushes, but they are worn out or something like that. This have the spring returning, and this one is not returning. And all of this because of this dust, I think. This dust is from the brushes. Yeah. Yes. And this here have a thread that will push out and pull in this rod. And I don't know for what are these three contacts here with these brushes. These are interesting. Okay, now I will wash these parts. This is not moving? No. I will wash these parts to better see them. Okay, now it's better. So this thing from here is the sensor, and to be honest, I don't know for what are these three things. I don't know exactly for what are that things. Let me see from here. I said pin 5 is the electric motor. Okay, and pin 1 the same is the electric motor. Okay, and these three things from here are connected with the brushes from the motor. You can see, let me show you in this way. You can see inside there, that is the collector, And this one from here and this one from here are two brushes. It's like a normal electric motor, but you can see from this pad, it's connected to this exterior ring. And from this pad and from this pad. From this pad, okay. Every ring, you see there are 1, 2, 3 and again. And one pad it's with the exterior ring, the second pad I think is with the middle, and the third pad is with the inner one. Oh, look, these are the brushes. Now it's easier. You can see this one have remained stuck. This was the problem, I think. This one have remained stuck because of that dust, the carbon dust that was made from these brushes. You can see them. And this is the collector where the that brushes will make contact. Nice. And how I will dismantle this thing to take out the motor. Okay, the board is connected here on these pins with the pins from the plug, I think. And now I want to take out this rotor. I want to remove it. I don't know if I broke something. I think I broke it. Yeah. I have disconnected the collector from the winding. Okay, now I understand why I have these three connections here. Because this motor, this electric motor, don't have a permanent magnet. The rotor and the stator are windings. Yeah, now everything it's yeah. That's why I need to have that connections, because this is connected to this one and this one. Three exterior winding. Yeah, this is a very powerful motor in this configuration. This explains everything. Okay, and now it's very simple. I want to remove this board from here to see what is on the other side. Perfect. This inside here is the sensor. I think I will be able to remove it from here. From what I'm seeing. It's not moving, but it's clearly a separate piece. This is here is just a case. Either way, these three pins are from this plug, these two pins are these two ones, and these four pins are from this position sensor. And this small board is the connection for the sensor, and I think this thing have a feedback from the winding in the sensor. I'm not sure, but this board have a protective layer, something similar to paint, and because of that I'm not able to see every trace, to trace every trace.
1 hour later.
Finally, I have managed to turn down this valve controller. After 1 hour of dealing with this electric motor, I have finally dismantled it. And this is everything. First thing first, I will start with the repairability of this system. From a scale of 1 to 10, this one it's a 99. This is built in such a way that we'll be not able to repair it. I will start with this part from here. This is the end part and this is the front part. This case, it's a whole case. Only we'll have the pins for the plug. These five pins are corresponding here, two pins here and three pins here, you can see them. That two pins are for the electric motor and the three pins are for the sensor. The position sensor, it's a magnetic sensor. This one is the sensor itself. Have this plunger from here. This is a permanent magnet here. This sensor, I think, from my experience, will never fail, ever, ever. This thing go inside here, no, in the other way, like so. This thing will go inside here. This will be mounted inside here. This is a cap that will keep everything here. After that, the electric part, the electronic part, the electric part, it's this thing from here. On this side have some capacitors, some resistors. This will be mounted inside here. These are the connections with the pins from the plug and from the sensor. And this here are the screws that will keep everything tied together. This sensor, it's pushed back depending on the position of the shaft. Next step is the electric motor. At the beginning of this video, before I will disassemble this completely, I was thinking that this rotor have windings, have copper windings, but no. This rotor, it's a permanent magnet. You can see it. This rotor is a permanent magnet and only the stator have copper windings. They have done something interesting here from my point of view. Because if you want to control an electric motor with the winding on the stator, you need an electronic control unit to control it, because here are three phases. So they have done something interesting. They have created this system like the winding was on the rotor and not on the stator. So how this system is working, here I have the brushes, classical brushes, like any electric motor, and the collector, the same like any electrical motor with the winding on the rotor. This will alternate between these pads, the voltage, And these pads are connected with these traces. One pad is the exterior trace, the next pad is the middle trace, and this pad is the inner trace. And the steps are repeating itself. You can see this is connected with this, and this with this, and so on. And these are the brushes that will make permanent contact here with this rotor to connect the exterior winding, like so, something like that. The main failure of this system is this thing from here. On this one, for example, this brush was stuck inside with the dust created by these brushes. The end cap have a keyway. You can see it is not round inside here. The shaft have the counter key, this thing from here. This shaft will enter in this end cap, and because of this type of key, the shaft won't turn. If the shaft is not turning, the rotor have the tread for this shaft, and when the rotor will spin, the shaft will be moved. You can see it. And this is how this electric valve is working. And the sensor have this plunger here. This will enter inside of the rotor on this side. And when the shaft is pulled inside of the valve, the shaft will push this plunger. And because of this, the sensor will know in which position is the shaft. Because this rotor have a hole in it. And last thing that I have found interesting is these two wires. You remember at the beginning of this video, I have seen these ends of these wires on the case of this valve. So I'm pretty sure that my assumption is correct. And when they will assemble this thing, will assemble the electric motor, will assemble the electronic part, the back with the sensor. In the groove where these two cases will meet together, they will put these wires, one here. Now the groove is not present here because I have cut open this valve, but they have put these wires here, something like that. One here and one here, like so. After that, they will bring together the front and the rear part. I think they will put them in some kind of vise or device that will keep a tension between these two parts. They will apply a voltage across these wires. These wires will become red hot, will melt the plastic, and the case will fuse together. This thing is quite interesting, and the way that this electric motor works, especially this thing. Now with this, it's very easy for me from now on to better understand this system, and when I will have some failures, I will know exactly what it's failing inside here. And I hope you also learned something new in this video. And this is all. I hope you learned something new. If this is the case, show me by hitting the like button. Thank you for watching these videos. Thank you for being with me. And till next time, stay awesome. Bye now.